Are you working on an existing Flutter code base and looking to cut down on your UI development process? Well, we have a new package in town to help you do just that. With the combination of FlutterFlow that lets you build UI using our drag and drop interface and our Flutter package that exposes the FlutterFlow classes, you can now export the generated UI code and add it to your existing Flutter app code base. Let's take an example. Think of this Flutter Gallery app. It's a great app around personal finance. Now, say you want to add a new feature like being able to pay bills with it. I added a button here that can make a payment page slide up from the bottom where I can put in my card info, choose my payment method, process the payment, and my bills will be cleared. Now, here's the catch. I will not be building the UI for this from scratch, not in Flutter, and technically not even in FlutterFlow. I mean, not from scratch at least. Instead, I found this great template in FlutterFlow which is similar to what I need, and I'm importing that into my FlutterFlow project. You're free to do any changes you like, whatever suits your design vision. In my case, I'm going to update the title and subtitle and also add some entry animations for the elements in this widget. Adding animations in FlutterFlow on action trigger or on page load is pretty straightforward. For example, on page load, I'm applying a slide up animation to our buttons here. I will apply similar animations to other elements, and once I'm happy with my final UI, I can export the code to my Flutter Gallery app. Let's quickly run all the animations in our builder, and you know what's cool? I didn't even need to launch the whole project to check out the final animation. I love how smooth that is. So now that we are happy with the final output, let's go to the developer menu and view the code. Here you see every widget contains two files. One is your widget file and another is the model file. Model files are useful to store paid state fields such as text field controllers or in this case the credit card state. So it's best to have them too. Now let's port the code. In this case, since we need the entire code of this component, we make sure we copy the entire widget file along with the imports. Now, I'm going to go back to my IDE and I have a folder for such components and I'm already ready with a new .dot file where I can paste the code. As mentioned earlier, we need the model file code too. You can drop it in the current file or start a new one, whatever fits your project setup. If it turns out you don't need it, maybe for a widget without any state fields, you can delete it later and clean up any references to it. Now the code is added, but there are tons of errors. Do not panic. This is because they don't have access to the FlutterFlow classes, which is solved by the new FlutterFlow UI package on pub.dev. Add this package to your pubspec.yaml file and run Flutter pubget. Now go back to your newly created file and replace all the FlutterFlow path imports with the package import. This will remove 95 to 99% of your errors. After that, if you spot any leftover code bits that don't make sense for your project, go ahead and toss them out. I just had to remove an app state watch call from my build method and that did the trick. Now, I'm going to add some Flutter code to open this payment screen as a bottom sheet, and now we can run and see the magic. And here we go, an entire payment info screen with credit card section, price breakdown, all that was built in a few minutes thanks to the useful FlutterFlow templates and exported to my existing Flutter project in under a few steps. I can also build this entire app in FlutterFlow, but since I have an existing project, now it is 10x easier to visually build entire new pages, components like this, or even small widget elements to add to a page and add them to my existing code base and streamline my workflow. Check out FlutterFlow UI on pub.dev and happy building.